sleeping for a sleeper?
Yeah, what number? What numbers are these?
I've got 11, 12.
11. 11. Thank you.
Yep, no worries.
Oi. Oops. I'm over 6 feet, and so my head basically reaches the ceiling. Gonna find out just how comfortable the bed is tonight. I'll turn this back on. But yeah, I guess this is the room. So, most people have said, I guess that's the bed, wrong light. Most of the videos that I saw said like the room is moderately comfortable if you're around six, a bit over six. And it looks like it could be. Hopefully I don't need to use the butt bed. Assuming these seats that you can see fully extend and then become a bed, that might be a bit more comfortable. Airflow and that's another Caltrain that's leaving. I had based on like what I saw at the station that I was at, there weren't too many people. But looking at the train, I'd say the train's probably about 60-70% full. Which it is a holiday weekend, so that is probably special. But yeah, most of the Caltrains that I saw were moderately empty, but I don't know how full Caltrain was on a good day. So, alright. There'll be some more, I guess. Excuse me. Oh, that doesn't work. How do I get to the next car? I have to go up?
You go upstairs, you pass between cars and you have to go.
Thank you.
Scan your ticket before you escape.
Now, you want to go to the bathroom or to the diner?
Diner. Okay. Bathroom's this way? Or bathroom's that way?
I'm trying to forgive myself. You're
ready
to stop. Thank
you.
Going the right
way. I got disoriented. Excuse me. Sure. So one thing I noticed was there didn't seem to be a blanket within the room. I guess part of it is there isn't really much place to put it. So if you get the sleeper car, you probably should just, as soon as you get in, ask for a blanket. You're probably going to need it. To take one of these paddles and sleep on, which is probably going to be more comfortable than just sleeping on the extended chairs. So it's about 11:30. I wasn't certain how long this plan is staying up. Part of this is, I guess, just the excitement of hopping on the train. It's the longest train ride I've ever been on. Probably gonna try and force myself to stay up an hour or so later than I usually would. I've stopped about 3 or 4 times already. If I remember the schedule correctly, we're somewhere between Oakland on our way to Sacramento, but none of these stops will be long. The first long stop that we will have won't be until after we cross into Oregon. But they had mentioned that there are going to be a couple of stops that people are going to be getting off on as we head up to Oregon. Well, pulled into Sacramento. It's probably to 20-30% slower than driving. Took about 3-4 hours, while if you were driving you could probably do it in 2.5-3, but still not bad. Video of the night. Yes, we can pick up tomorrow morning whenever I wake up. Hopefully I wake up before we cross into Oregon, but that is not looking likely. Anyways, this is how dark the room is, or how bright the room is, with the ceiling lights on. This is how dark it is. There's some light coming in through the curtain. There are Velcro straps that I might affix, or I might just leave it. And then, for those of you who want a bit of a reading light, there's that reading light. And I don't know, the light itself is pretty bright. You probably could read from it. If I wanted to read, I'd still leave the ceiling light on. But I am starting to feel tired. I'll probably fairly dark. Don't know if you can quite make it out, but some of the light is still coming through the curtain. But for the most part, it is quite dark.
There's a little time to get the bags off the train. They'll bring them on up to the depot area for you, where you can collect them there. And that's it, folks. We're early. So you'll have a little time to step off and stretch a bit if you want to. If you decide to take advantage of that, please be mindful of the fact that there is a set of exposed rail track between the depot and the train. And we would appreciate it very much if you'd not walk across the exposed rail, but stay in the designated walkways. It is safer for everybody that way. Klamath Falls, Oregon, coming up next.
Just like to mention, if anybody has any phone calls or downloads to make, we will be losing cell reception here shortly for a couple hours as we head up through the pass, up and over about 5,000 feet elevation. The view on the right-hand side is going to get really good. You're going to see some lakes, peaks, valleys, reservoirs. We're also going to be going through a series of tunnels, roughly 24 of them. This is a long stretch, 3 hours to Eugene. If you have any phone calls or download movies, games, now's the time to do it. We will be losing cell reception shortly for about 2 hours. Next stop, Eugene. Thank you.
Social distance, please. time ago, but you're like, it's
last hour or so.
Yeah, these are some of the lovely hills of Oregon. It's one of the reasons it's one of my favorite states. Even though it's taken a long time to get back to. Some of us open words on the other.
No, I just want to make sure. All you have to do is ring that yellow bell. Your attendant will come, take that order from you, deliver it to you. That car is open and serving for those sleeping car passengers only.
Thank you.
Portland's a 45-minute layover if we're on time.
Okay.
So, but this one's only about 5 to 10 minute run if we're on time or not.
Yeah, we'll just be here in about
10 minutes.
Thank you.
So, 45 minutes, roughly an hour in early. An hour to keep awake.
2.5 hours? Okay.
Turns out we were about 5 minutes behind schedule for Eugene, Oregon. We were told originally that we would be able to walk around about for Eugene. But the actually, a decent number of people have been in Eugene. Are they going all the way to Seattle or Portland? I guess we'll find out. Also means I should probably prep my seat. And so after about 5 minutes, I guess it was time to say goodbye to Eugene, Oregon. So I was given the choice of brownie or blondie. I have no idea what a blondie is, but apparently it is a toffee brownie. Let's see how good that is.
notice we have a freight train on the right-hand side of us passing. We may be coming to a stop here, so if you can all just remain in your seats. No need to come down and crowd the lower level. Let's just remain in our seats. We are getting close to the Portland station, but we are possibly coming to a stop here.
Attention, please. For those of you that boarded here in Portland with us, on behalf of the Portland-based conductors and the Los Angeles Onboard Service crew, we'd like to welcome you aboard the Coast Starlight. A few safety reminders to make your trip more enjoyable. Amtrak requires that face masks be worn at all times when walking about, moving about the train, when sitting at your seat. The only time you may remove your mask is when you're actively eating or drinking. Please maintain your social distance when you're patronizing the lounge car. And our lounge car only accepts debit or credit cards. We do not take cash. Please help your attendants keep the car, the train clean by disposing of your trash in the trash receptacles that are located in each car. Shoes are mandatory and required at all times when moving about on Amtrak trains. And please only dispose of the proper paper products in our lavatories. They're very delicate. And they will clog up and we won't have restrooms. It'll be very inconvenient. No personal consumption of alcohol is allowed in the coaches. If you desire a cocktail, we do have a lounge car that does offer spirits and different beers and wine. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, no smoking of anything is allowed on any Amtrak train, and this includes e-cigarettes. And please brace yourself when walking and moving about our trains. Hold on to handrails when going down the stairwell. In between cars, there's red and white handrails. Hold on to those. And hold on to seat backs. And overhead luggage racks. Again, we'd like to welcome you aboard the Coast Starlight.
A wide variety of goodies for you. You got fresh brewed coffee, juices, sodas, chips, candy, pastries, burgers, hot dogs, pizzas, macaroni and cheese, and of course, for those of you that are of age and with the proper ID, we have ice cold beer, wine, and cocktails for you. So once again, folks, cafe is open and serving lower level observation lounge fare. Once again, folks, we are credit debit card only. Thank you and welcome aboard. And also, folks, please do not rush on down at once. Social distance as best you can. And I'm not closing again anytime soon. Thank you.
You're being loud.
That's right. No trash can up here. You know, I don't know.
I took it down.
Destination, and it has been a long day and a half, but not too bad. I think it was still a fun trip. Let's see how I feel after the return trip. This just seems to be a huge shipping container yard. Saw a bunch of FedExes. Saw a bunch of this company named X that I've never seen before. They're Swift, obviously. Intermodal, also another company I've never heard before. Thank you. flight seemed big enough for outright plane assembly, but they probably do like plane repair. Oh yeah, I just checked the map, and actually the train's trying to take me by the King County International Airport, which should be pretty darn close to the train station, I think.
Just make sure you're not forgetting any items that may be important to you. Prepare yourself as we make our way to Seattle K Street Station. Again, we are less than 10 minutes out of our last and final stop, Seattle K Street Station.
Safe.